pines.
Where else would it be from?
You know that?
No, man, no, no.
Who sent you?
Pilcher? No, man, Pilcher's dead. Who are you? Look, you mind easing up on the knife work there, buddy? Huh? I'm not one of our little mutant friends, in case you can't tell. We're on the same side here, I promise you. Please.
Who's in charge? Is it Pam?
No. No,
Pam, Pam did the deed, actually. At least that's what I hear. I haven't seen her for a while. Now there's a kid in charge now. His name's Jason.
We love him. Where the hell are we? I woke up in some pit. Do they put people in pits?
They do a lot of things.
Be gone.
So wait, Pilcher sent you out here? What do you do to piss him off?
Nothing. A bunch of us were sent. Scout, report back. Look for other communities, other survivors.
Yeah, and then what do you find?
Found you.
I'll get Lucy to wash her hair. Lucy? Lucy?
Your story.
Group B woke up in paradise about 5 years ago, I think. Or before invasion.
I don't mean that. Why are you laughing?
I colored outside the lines.
Seems like a harsh punch.
Yeah, I agree. But, at least I'm in the clear now, right?
Depends.
I'm going home.
Somebody I gotta see. But, I might just put you right back out here.
Thank you.
Why did you go out there? How far did you get? I'll be alone. Guess that's something that we still don't know.
How's he doing?
You'd have to ask him that.
He's not really talking to us right now. That's why I'm asking you.
I know this doctor, so I'm not talking either. Little thing called the Hippocratic Oath.
We're living a different time now. Some of those old rules don't apply. Is he stable, doctor? Mentally, I mean.
What part of what I said did you not understand?
I understand your position, but Adam Hassler is a hero. You see, Pilcher sent a dozen nomads in a dozen directions out beyond the fence to report back on everything. And Adam's the only one who's ever returned. This is big news for Wayward Pines. We need to know what he's seen, what he knows, even the smallest piece of information.
Then ask him. Ask him.
They come to you when you're sick. Remember, Dr. Yedlin? That's when you care for them. That's when they trouble you.
If they trouble you.
With your manner, sometimes it's hard to tell. They're my responsibility all the time. They're like my extended family in a way.
Like Dan Pilcher? Me?
I know nothing about that.
I know she's dead.
I worry about all of them. They keep me up at night. And I'm willing to do whatever it takes to protect them. I'll make the tough choices. Would you?
Thank you.
walk you through it. I will not let you hurt him. No one is above the rules. You leave me no choice. I'll be seeing Jason in 30 minutes for a research briefing, and you know I'll have to report this.
Report what? Exactly. Rebecca Edmund's not following the rules. Rebecca Edmund needs to be reined in. Reckon. Do you really want to pick that fight, Megan? Because I'm not sure that this is going to be a winner for you.
You're being very self-destructive, Rebecca. If only you could see it.
Issy, come on in. Come home with me tonight, I'll walk you to school in the morning, okay? Why did you come back? Is it me? Are you trying to help me? Lucy's going to be staying with us for a few days.
Hey.
The shower is up on the left. I'll be with you in a few moments to show you where you're sleeping.
Where are her parents?
They died on vacation. She lives with her brother and the academy with the other orphans. I look out for her now. She got a period a couple of days ago, and they wanted to enroll her in the fertility program.
That girl. She's what, 11?
Yeah.
Well, how does that work? Do they inseminate them?
They pair them up, and they put them into these procreation rooms at the academy. I think they do things the old-fashioned way.
Old-fashioned is a six-pack and borrowing your brother's car, your dad's cologne, and the radio. It's not. Who picks them? Who pairs them up?
I don't know. Not one person, I think.
And it's by looks or intelligence? Size, maybe? It's eugenics. And you know this.
I'm on your side, Theo. I agree with you. I'm trying my best to protect her from what I can for as long as I can. This is why she's here with us.
CJ told me why they're going outside. It's not the food. He says it's to give hope. Which on some level makes sense to me. But every time one thing here seems almost rational, two things pop up that make absolutely no sense at all.
So we talk, and we try to make sense of what we can.
The talk is all survival. It's not about living. This isn't life.
Work hard, be happy, enjoy your life in the way it finds.
Lynn. You know it was you.
What? Listen, what are you talking about?
You told her. What if I told her things about you?
What things?
I hate you.
Thank you.
year 4032. Man's destruction of the environment has created evolutionary aberrations known as abbeys that rule the earth. One man saw the catastrophe coming. He created an ark for mankind and selected a chosen few to sleep for 2,000 years to defy mankind's extinction. Surrounded by mountains and protected by an electric fence, the last of humanity left alive on Earth do their best to survive in a town called Wayward Pines.
Previously on Wayward Pines,
Pilch has sent a dozen young men in a dozen directions up beyond the fence, and Adam's the only one who's ever returned.
They're gone.
This is a rare opportunity. With the Abbeys retreated, we can work without fear.
I'm gonna come with you.
One thing here seems almost rational. Two things pop up that make absolutely no sense at all.
Every member of our community has a duty to ensure the future of the human race. Lucy has a choice.
Actually, Rebecca, she really doesn't.
I don't want to be alone. Frank, help me with your sister.
You told her.
The Abbeys are gone, Doctor. We have a chance to secure our future. Let's start forging a new path.
You're underestimating me.